God, I'm never gonna live this down. Like, in my sister Maggie's for everything. We call it Maggie time in real time. And she knows, and there's not even, won't even get in trouble, because I think that actually her universe just moves at a different pace to everybody else's.
Yeah. But you know, where you had the half an hour to her time.
No, but now I just, what I do is I get onto her daughter, so Mag will be there. I'll be there in 5 minutes, I'm just passing Man Point or something like that, and then I get on the phone. Hi, is it where are you? Still in heaven? Yeah. I kind of know, so Maggie time and real time are completely different. You're a stickler. I remember having a conversation with my sister when I was started going through all that as well, and I was very much in denial until I was in my late 30s, to be quite honest, because I remember thinking, I don't want this to be a chronic thing, I don't want it to come back, surely I'll take these tablets and that will fix me and then I'll be fine, it will never come back. And it's an overwhelming feeling to actually have to admit that the problem you have is actually chronic. Was it a relief to you when you find it, you have to wait till you're outside of it and then you realise, oh my God, I did all that, or I went through all of that and I didn't cop it till afterwards.
Yeah.
Yeah, it does happen, doesn't it? And it's cyclical and you're like, oh my God, I can't believe it happened again. But, I mean, you're the same.
I'm
a bit pinny here, I have to admit. I have a patch here. I swear to God, I have a comb over.
You want to get naked before you're 40 or something.
Ah, Jeannie Mac, I know you'd bring that. No. That was a joke. I do in my ear. That was a joke that I said in an interview 2 months ago that suddenly appeared everywhere yesterday. I swear to God, half the world and his mother thinks I'm going to get my melons out of here. It ain't happening, lads. Not at all. I would spare the greater Irish public the view of me naked. And Dara already kindly offered to me in the Sunday World in the nip, but no.
It's important to love what you're doing. And I think there's been so much misinformation over the years. And listen, I'm the most fucking well-known yo-yo dieter in Ireland at the moment because a lot of misinformation. And I am, at the moment, the weight I think I'm at now anyway, I would have dieted quite severely to get there over the last, like badly and crash dieted over the last number of years. All I've done in the last few months is have breakfast, which is very simple, old-fashioned 3 meals a day, but we're so bombarded by so much do this diet, the Atkins diet, the caveman diet, the no carbs, no anything. It is the hard sell on everything, isn't it?
Part of being a grown-up, I'm at a passport experience.